I know a lot of you guys have actually hit me up on my Instagram like, girl, go get your thyroid checked. But guess what? I already know. I actually was diagnosed with hypothyroidism as a teenager when I was 15 years old. So to help bring awareness to this disorder, we've invited board certified integrative medicine physician, Dr. Cory Maharani here. Woo! To break it all down for you. So joining us, doctor.
Yes.
Okay. For those that don't know, what exactly does your thyroid do?
So first of all, I wanted to congratulate you guys on your award. And thank you for having me on the show.
Yeah.
So the thyroid is a butterfly-shaped gland, and it sits in your neck right here, and it produces the thyroid hormone. Mm-hmm. Now, the thyroid hormone regulates the metabolism of every single cell in the body.
Wow.
So think of the thyroid as your gas pedal of the body. So if you're pressing on that gas pedal and it's not going anywhere, it's not working.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Trust
now, if
me,
someone has noticed extra weight gain, could it be because of a thyroid issue?
Absolutely. So women are 5 to 8 times more likely than men to have a thyroid condition.
Mm-hmm.
And more than 20 million people in the United States suffer from thyroid disorders.
20 million.
That's
I'm
a lot.
One of them.
And a vast majority of them don't even know that they have a thyroid disorder.
I had no idea.
Yeah. Okay, so what signs should you look for if you think you might have a thyroid condition?
So in addition to weight gain, you can have chronic fatigue.
Okay.
In fact, that's one of the most common reasons for visiting the doctor. But you could also have depression. You could have dry skin, weak fingernails, thinning hair, severe PMS. And ladies, if you are the coldest person in the room, guess what? You might have a thyroid disorder.
That was one of mine.
Interesting.
Well, how is it that people can see it, though, sometimes? Is there anything from a look?
Yeah, they say it swells.
You can sometimes have a goiter. But
very
oftentimes, women don't have a goiter.
Got it. Okay, so what's the best way to check if you think you have a thyroid problem?
So it's a blood test, and it is the gold standard is the TSH, which also stands for thyroid stimulating hormone, and it is the signal from the brain to the thyroid gland to make the thyroid hormone.
Okay.
So there's normal levels, which is between 0.4 and 4, and then there's when it's elevated greater than 10, that's when we're dealing with hypothyroidism. This is where the thyroid gland is underproducing, mm-hmm. and you have all of those symptoms that I talked about. Now, you can also have a level where it's borderline between 4 and 10. So some doctors will treat this and some doctors won't. I treat and I have good results.
Okay, just to be clear, what's hyper and what's hypo?
Okay, I was getting there.
Okay.
So when the level is less than 0.4, this is when you're dealing with hyperthyroidism.
And what is hyper?
That is hyper. When the TSH is low, it's less than 0.4.
But what are the symptoms of hyper versus hypo?
Got it. So symptoms of hyperthyroidism include anxiety, heart palpitations, insomnia, jitteriness, feeling just angry, and even frequent bowel movements. So these are symptoms of hyperthyroidism. And then also feeling very hot, having hot sensitivity.
Almost can be a sign. The opposite of hypo.
Exactly.
Okay, now what kind of treatments are out there for either hyper or hypo?
So the most commonly prescribed thyroid medication for hypothyroidism is Synthroid, also known as levothyroxine or T4. This is synthetic.
Yep.
There is a natural form of thyroid hormone. It's called Armour Thyroid, which I prescribe. It's bioidentical. In the past, this medication was not standardized, mm-hmm. so most doctors still think it's not, but it is now.
Great.
However, they don't prescribe it much, and for the doctors that do, like myself, my patients get great results with it.
Yeah.